The Resident Evil 2 remake. You know it, I know it. It is known that it exists, and for the most part, people love it. I say for the most part because I know there are people out there who dislike this game purely because it wasn't the Resident Evil 2 they envisioned. But hey, that is A-OK to feel that way. I just don't want to hear about it in any way, shape or form. But did you know there was a Resident Evil 2 marketing pitch that would have used some sort of social media ARG mobile game thing in the build up for the launch of the game? Well, apparently there was. According to SamuraiEdge85 on Twitter, that is. But they are pretty on point with everything and anything Resident Evil, so I trust them. Marketing slides were created and uploaded by David Betancourt, who was a freelance graphic design and motion graphics artist. And that was fucking hard to say for some reason. So in this video, we are going to take a look at that cancelled tie-in Resident Evil 2 marketing proposal thing that never saw the light of day. Until now. There were several key parts in the marketing proposal, and we are going to go through each and every one of them. Think of this as like a PowerPoint presentation, but with my seductive voice, accompanied by people shooting zombies in the fucking face, and Sherry being caught by Chief Irons because this section is fucking bullshit! The first part was going to be an in-depth video series. According to the marketing proposal, each of the three video series would follow the same format. Leverage multiple social media channels in order to reach as wide an audience as possible, while keeping them engaged with shareable content. That is some damn marketing speak right there, and I just felt dirty saying it. You are all ants in the eyes of corporations. The three series would have been Monster Breakdowns, Weapon Guides, and Lore and Systems. The Monster Breakdowns would have been stylized umbrella scientific reports, which showcase everything the player needed to know about enemy encounters and their history. The Weapons Guides would have been framed as RPD training videos designed to help players understand how to better utilize their arsenal, or in layman's terms, how to shoot innocent people who were quote-unquote resisting. Lore and Systems would have looked into the corporate conspiracies and failed experiments Umbrella is famously known for. That's a really shit thing to be known for, like if you're a corporation that's like has stock being shared and stuff. I don't understand how the fuck these guys ever became successful. These would have been presented as a detective's investigation with Resident Evil lore and any system changes to the game being explained in an easily digestible way. I think this would have kind of been like a reference to Chris investigating Umbrella after the Arklay Mountain incident, before he decided to take a vacation in Europe and not tell his sister, who came looking for him in a city infested with zombies. So, you know, sibling stuff. Each of the video series would have followed a three-step format. The first would be to tease people with small clues about upcoming videos on Instagram and Twitter. That way, it would get those hardcore Resi fans salivating from every orifice that has the ability to salivate. The next step would be to release the full video on YouTube with small excerpts uploaded on Instagram and Twitter. And finally, an in-depth live Q&A would have been streamed on Twitch, where Capcom staff would answer questions about the recent video and be abused by randoms because the game doesn't have fixed camera angles. The second, and probably the most interesting part, was the creation of a mobile game tie-in called Resident Evil 2 Demastered. It would have been a game with a 32-bit aesthetic containing roguelike dungeons where players would navigate a series of areas from Resident Evil 2. The players would dispatch enemies with guns and work to unlock new content. Developer Jupiter Lighthouse was suggested to create the game, and that was the perfect pick. Resident Evil 2 Demastered would have been a little humorous title that would have poked fun at itself and the survival horror genre in general. And this would be the first time Jupiter Lighthouse would work on a game such as this. They previously released a game called Prototype Mansion, and that game was a short parody of classic Resident Evil and survival horror games, and I don't know, maybe I'll make a video on it. In Prototype Mansion, players would explore a mansion, obviously, they would find keys to unlock doors and shoot zombies, but not too many, or you would run out of bullets. The game was also a love letter to Resident Evil, but also poked fun at the conventions of the classic survival horror genre, and I just said that twice, but I'm not taking it out. We don't fucking edit in this channel. Anyway, you can even see images of Prototype Mansion in the marketing pitch. Since the pitch kind of wanted Resident Evil 2 Demastered to capture that same visual presentation and lighthearted tone, it makes sense they would go for a developer who was already well-versed in making those types of games. The game would have also offered pre- or post-launch promotional content for Resident Evil 2, but they were also looking towards the future. The pitch planned for the game to be expanded as a persistent mobile title that would also tie into multiple Resident Evil games. The marketing proposal also showed off a physical version of the game that could have maybe been used of the PlayStation 1. It even included live-action photographs of pretty mediocre cosplay, which, to be honest, is most cosplay.
Why are you booing me? I'm right!
And on the front of the cover was a $4.99 sticker to emphasize the self-aware, low-quality take of the game. But whether this was purely done as part of the marketing slideshow or would have been an actual physical release is unknown. I kind of wish it happened because I want that shit in my collection. So all of this sounds really cool and fun. But since we never got it, you're probably asking, what happened? Well, that question is a bit hard to answer. Samurai Edge 85 said Capcom USA turned down the pitch, but for what reason is unclear. It seems like a pretty stupid decision to just not do this, to be honest, as all of this, especially the mobile game, would have been fantastic to experience. You know, fuck it, I'd play that game while I'm taking my morning shit. It'd be better time spent than scrolling through Twitter and realizing, I hate everybody. But hey, we are all well aware that game companies are weird, so, you know.
But I just realized something. I have cards. And I'm a magician.
And that is about it. I hope Capcom actually does something like this in the future, but with the Resident Evil 3 remake just around the corner, I doubt we will see anything like it anytime soon. And I've just dated my video horribly. But thank you all for watching this, and I hope you enjoyed it. I know this isn't a conventional cancel horror games video, but hey, sometimes you gotta mix things up a bit so that the crushing darkness of reality does not completely consume you. If you did like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe. All of that really helps the channel grow, and big numbers are a big turn on. If you want to take our relationship to the next step, you can support the channel on Patreon. For as little as $1, you'll get access to my videos one day early and my Discord. Higher contributions give you access to a monthly Q&A video. You can ask me all of your burning questions and I'll try to answer them. Big thanks to Devon John Malone, Colby Ball, Sam Barclay, Sleight of Tongue, and Walter for supporting the channel. I will see you all in the next video. Bye!